Brooke.
Hi. It's nice to see you.
Brooke is singing You Must Love Me, which is the new song that Tim Rice and I wrote for the Evita movie.
We had it all. You believed in me.
I don't think that girl had a clue about what she was singing about. OK, let's stop. It's worth thinking what this song's really about.
So he had me walk around the piano, and he told me about the background behind this song.
She's dying, and she knows it.
Yes.
But she's actually saying to him, you must love me, please.
You know, he looked into my eyes, and it was like, I got it.
Frightened, you'll slip.
I was quite pleased because she was singing as if she meant it.
Me.
That's terrific.
It's probably been one of the most powerful moments I've had on the show so far.
You are a wonderful natural actress. This is the question. Is this girl going to be able to keep that up? I don't know. But if she can, I think she's got something there that perhaps hasn't been seen before.
This isn't where we were.
I'm sorry.
Where do we go from here? This isn't where we intended to be. We had it all. You believed in me. I believed in you. Certainties disappear. What do we do for our dreams to survive? How do we keep all our passions alive as we used to do?
Check it out, dog. Check it out. For me, I mean, this wasn't great. There were parts of it that were good once you got started. But the one thing that I did like that you did is that at least you listened to Andrew Lloyd Webber, because the most important thing that I think you guys can all take from this night is you need to believe what you're singing. That, I kind of got that, the vulnerability and everything for you, but vocally was just a little tough.
You must never start and stop. Just having said that, this is the biggest show and biggest platform that no matter what, you're strong enough and you're great enough as an artist to pick up the pieces. What I did love about this performance, Brooke, is you didn't overact. You just were you and you did sing the songs, and anything that became part and parcel or broken a little bit vocally was an emotional strength of yours. It sounded great.
The talented
well,
Simon
this
Cowell.
Is why I love live TV. I mean, it was so dramatic, the beginning, you know? The trouble is, Brooke, it completely threw you, because at that point, you were so tense trying to remember the song, your voice was straining in the middle of it all, that it actually became quite uncomfortable. So, this is a tricky one.
Yeah.
I think you're going to be very disappointed when you watch this back.
Brooke White, ladies and gentlemen. So, going back to starting the first time, what happened? What went wrong? Why'd you start over?
I lost the lyric. First time I've done that on this show.
And Paula's advice to not stop and start again. Simon, if it were you, what would you have done?
I would have done exactly what she did. You know, if she's forgotten the words.
Yeah.
You know, I thought it was, I thought it was actually a very brave thing to do. You know, it's your opportunity, why not?
And your heart must have been racing that second time, huh?
You are such a believable artist, and your strength is there, and people love you. You could have sang anything that fell from the heart until you picked
well,
up again.
She can't make up the song, Paula.
Yeah, no, no exactly. If you forget the words, you did the right thing. Stop and start again, but just don't let the nerves get you.
It's
live exactly.
Television.
To that point, we've got to keep moving. So, Brooke, come on over here. Let's give out the phone numbers. It is live. You never know what's going to happen. The numbers for Brooke, 1-866.